Good evening, TheoTrade. This is Corey Rosenblumen. You're watching the Theo Nightly Video for the 6th of April here in 2021. And we have a little bit of market action going on. An hour before the market closes is when I'm recording this video. And we're going to look for another snapback, rubber band pullback. We'll talk about that, give some levels, give some target updates for the short-term trader. Remember, these videos in the evening are designed to find what's working right now and what's likely to work right now. Is would you rather be long if you have not put a position on at this exact moment? Would you rather get long right now, buy some calls, or would you rather buy some puts? And we'll look at some of the past performances in similar situations. Let's start right there. Let's clean the chart. I'm gonna look at the S&P futures. We'll put this actually to the SPX. That way there's less annotation. And a little bit clearer chart. Get that trend line away from the chart. So what we're looking at here is the continued uptrend. This takes us back 1 year. What I want to highlight are similar periods to what is happening right now. So what is happening right now? We have an uptrend in price. What is an uptrend? It's a series of higher highs and higher lows. And that continues as the time goes on. So this is as we speak here at the beginning of April, the market's into an upswing at a new all-time high, which is very exciting to the bulls, but to the bears or hedged or traders looking to put on safety plays, that is a little frustrating. But are there similar points in time where this happened? And the answer is absolutely. Let's just start back to June. What's the context? Uptrend in motion. We define that uptrend again as a series of highs and lows. Maybe we can add rising moving averages, maybe add some linear regression. It doesn't matter. It's just higher highs and higher lows, and the market's definitely going up. Or to be super simple, here's the bottom left, here's the top right. And that has been the trend of the price of the index. So where are we right now? What's likely to work? Is it getting calls, getting long at the top of an upswing? Well, let's look at that strategy. How would that have worked? At the top, sometimes, not terribly, but more than not, that would have been a losing short-term strategy. What would have been a winning short-term strategy? That's what we want to discuss. That's what we want to highlight in today's video. And that is going to be, I'll change the color to red, and just highlight rubber band snapbacks. That is one. That is another. This is into June. So June for a few days, September for a few days. Might not count that, but October was a sell swing, not quite as dramatic. Still a sell swing, it was. Not much to speak of. November, December, January. The most recent one was February, although that wasn't superb or stellar. And then we had the February pullback. We had the March snapback. Might we now have the April snapback? And if so, what levels might a trader target? On the SPX, we'll extend our moving averages, and that would be about 3895 on the S&P. Possibly back to 4,000 is a really easy target to play for, again, for what's working right now or what's happening to the short-term trader. These, again, we'll call them or label them rubber band snapback. Rubber band snapback. All that is you think of this as a focal point, you have that rubber band stretch, let go of the rubber band, and the next move of the rubber band, at least, is going to be the snapback. Is this guaranteed to work as a foolproof strategy? Certainly not. But that's what we're looking at to be working as the most effective strategy in the market at this exact moment. So all that being said, take the charts off. Is this similar in the Nasdaq? We'll look at the Nasdaq futures to assess. And where were those snapbacks in the S&P or in the Nasdaq futures? And those, not a lot, but the most recent big one was here in September into October, not a lot. And of course, the most recent was February. Notice that the Nasdaq being a little bit stronger or a little bit weaker, my apologies, weaker than the S&P is not pushing all-time highs. For those who trade the Dow mini futures, we'll look at that. We won't go to the snapback rubber band concept or conversation, but nonetheless, you can plan out these levels for a pullback just by looking at what the market has done in the past. And the Russell is also a little bit weaker, and that pullback or snapback might take us back to, that's more range or box centered, possibly to 2150. You can do the same logic within the context of each of the ETFs. We'll pull those up now, which include the financials. K is technology, and that's similar to the QQQ or the Nasdaq index. Y is consumer discretionary, and that is a new high. We won't go through all. I is industrials. B is materials. We'll take a look at energy. Energy is XLE. Staples, which is defensive and not very bullish for the broad market to see staples outperforming. That's consumer staples. That's things we have to have in a recession or in good times and bad. Think toothpaste. Think cleaning supplies. If it's a recession, you're still going to clean your house. You're still going to brush your teeth. So that's a difference in consumer discretionary, which is things you don't have to do. We don't have to travel. We don't have to book hotels. We don't have to go to casinos or fun things. That's discretionary income. But in good times and bad, staples. Still have to use those. And that's a good way to look at the market strength. V is healthcare. And finally, U is utilities, which is a little bit weaker. And utilities, to me at least, seem to be a little bit like the bond market. Speaking of the bond market, we have had this sell swing in from the TLT, tradable ETF, from about 170. Now that's been a downtrend. The rubber band snapback has not been to the downside. It's actually been to the upside. So when the market gets overextended from its moving average or just from its declining trend line, the snap backs on the rubber band take us higher. You can call these counter trend or snapback rubber band rallies. And the other way, it's be a snapback fall for the S&P. And view this picture on the bond market, ZB, ZN, which are futures contracts. That picture is going to look relatively similar in the gold market. We have a level in gold at 1700, and we are seeing a strong bounce off of that support shelf, or just a key level. It's not magic, it's just a key level to put trades, take trades off, target. And similarly, when a market is overextended, get that snapback, get that rubber band to come back to the upside. So that's how I look at markets, at least. Even in a trending environment or event, nothing goes straight down. We do have these snapbacks. And if we're playing into a market that is, at least for the S&P, overbought, the next move of the market is more likely than not back to the downside. So little short-term targets or short-term puts or put spreads would play off in the ES, in the SPY, or probably in any number of stocks that you might be looking at for the short term. Before we end tonight's video, we're at the beginning of April, and let's just do a quick scan, as I'm used to doing on the videos, which is the strong stocks getting stronger. These include stocks making new 52-week highs, or in some cases, all-time highs. And I sort this by market cap. So it is just S&P 500, stocks making new yearly highs, 52-week highs, technically. Doesn't have a list for all-time highs. We can do that if we work with the data, but I don't do that in this particular scan. I want to find stocks that are strong getting stronger. And those include market leaders, big monsters of tech symbols, Google, Facebook, and then we go down to Home Depot, McDonald's, Honeywell, Lowe's, Starbucks, Target, and the list goes on. Technically, we have 62. So 62 stocks in the S&P 500 are making new all-time highs. And outside the scope of this video for today's discussion, but there is Google. There is Facebook that is strong. They just made a new high. There is Home Depot as it loads. And that's just relentlessly strong. As someone who enjoys the trending markets, trending stocks, that is just relentless. And that is difficult to get long. It's also difficult to short, which is the risk to shorting a market that is overbought and overextended. It will work more than half the time in terms of multiple trades, but we can never be sure which exact trade we're about to take is going to work or not. And sometimes they do not work. meaning sometimes a rubber band snapback that we expect or want to happen, like these, will not pull back. And that will result in financial losses. Again, that's part of the fun of being a trader. We don't have any foreknowledge of the future. McDonald's just pushed up to highs, and we have lows, and we'll finish up with Starbucks and Target. Again, just name a few. So even a stock that is strong getting stronger. Now, my preference is to try to get long on the pullbacks. But again, the purpose of the videos is not what do you do in the next couple of weeks? Get the pullback and get long. It's what do you, this is the strategy for the longs, the buys. It's what do you do right now? And as we are here at the beginning of April, the strategy at the moment, if you are willing to put the trades on and take the risk, is to play for that rubber band snap back fall retracement or sell swing. But again, for the next few sessions into the next week at best, no matter what trade style you take, being patient, waiting for the long to set up, or taking the short right now, be careful, be safe, carefully guard your open positions. This is Corey Rosenblum with tonight's Theo video update for April 6th, 2021.